I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making grape nuts pie. Now that's going to be a nice summer treat because it's a frozen pie, and I've been doing a few things like that for you over the summer. I just feel more like it during summer than I do in the wintertime, and probably you'll have the need to get cooled off a little more in the summer. So let's start with a large bowl, and into that bowl we're going to put frozen yogurt. And what I've chosen here is, it's vanilla. You should use vanilla because of the other flavors that we're going to add. I've chosen a low-fat variety. You need 2 cups of it. I dipped out this measuring cup, which is 2 cups, about an hour ago and just let it sit so I'd be able to stir it around because it's very solid in the container when it's frozen. But you're going to let it thaw out a little bit so you'll be able to stir it in with the other ingredients. This is probably more than you need to let it sit. Next, I have vanilla pudding. It's instant and it's sugar-free, fat-free. Now you can get any variety that you like of the small box of vanilla pudding. It doesn't have to be instant, but that's better because you know it's just like making the instant pudding and it's cooked and it's ready. I prefer the sugar-free, fat-free, but you may want to get the kind that has sugar because if you don't agree with the sweetener used, then that might be your preference. But just sprinkle that in along with your frozen yogurt. And next comes peanut butter. Now this is crunchy peanut butter. I set these things out just to let you know what I was actually putting in. This is 1/2 cup that we will place in there. And then we have Cool Whip. This is just the original Cool Whip, but if you want to make it lighter, then you can get the light variety. It will have less calories. You can get the fat-free variety if that is something that you're looking out for. 1 cup. So you want to just have that thawed and get the 1 cup out. And then we have one last item here, and it is grape nut cereal. And we need 3/4 cup of that. So we're going to place all this together and then just stir very gently, not to mess too much with the light items like the frozen yogurt and also the Cool Whip. We just want to get this together. So I have this all mixed together, and you want to be really gentle with it because you want to have some puffiness at the end. And if you feel like you might have a problem with that, then save the Cool Whip to last. Get everything mixed together, including the frozen yogurt, which is slightly thawed, but then just fold in the Cool Whip. Although I put everything together and just was very gentle in the folding. Once you have this together, it goes into a Pyrex dish or just a pie plate of any kind. Let's just use our spoon and let that go in, and then we'll even it out a little bit. This has a lot of flavor in it, and I think you'll enjoy it once it's actually prepared and chilled. Actually frozen the way it's supposed to be served. And you may have a few streaks of peanut butter like that, but that's just good when you cut down through it, when you see that. So just level off the top a little bit, and it's ready to go to the freezer. This is a frozen pie, so we're going to freeze it till we can cut it in wedges. Here is our grape nuts pie, and I think it's ready to cut. It's only been in the freezer a couple of hours, but it's pretty thin, and I tested it right here, and it seemed like it's solid enough. And this has a serrated edge, and you should use something with a serrated edge. And it seems solid enough that I'll be able to have it hold its shape, just cutting my way over to the edge. So I cut down the other side and loosened the back, and I'm going under this with a smaller, more wedge-shaped pie server because I think it'll come out more cleanly. So let's go all the way to the center and then try to pry it up without breaking it apart too much. I'm going to use my fork over here to hold this down. And the other side. And there we have it. So we're bringing it over to actually a large plate, but this is our serving plate today. And the mint that I was using to dress up the whole pie will become the mint that is used here for this little piece. Here I am ready to take a bite of the pie. So I always go to the tip. Everything's there. And you remember the things we put in here were frozen vanilla yogurt and also a dry vanilla mix for making puddings and pie fillings. There were also grape nuts and also peanut butter that had nuts in it. So it's full of really good tasting things. Also some Cool Whip. So let's see how this goes together. Nice and chewy. There will be a lot of bran in this pie, which is unusual for a fluffy pie like this, because it has the grape nuts. The grape nuts are really good. The peanut butter is really good. You can sort of pick out all the individual flavors. And I think this is something that you'll enjoy and not feel tremendously guilty about having a dessert, because it does have some good things in it.